they've got their adoption meeting tomorrow.
Yeah, I know that. But I found them drinking on a park bench. He had nowhere else to go.
We are not a hostel for down-and-out ex-boyfriends.
We took him in.
Exactly. We're at full capacity.
Look, I don't want him here any more than you do, but I'm worried about the state of mind. Where's your compassion?
It evaporated when I found the remnants of his last meal in the kitchen sink.
He told me last night he tried to kill himself.
Tom. Kyle. Nancy. Thank you for your generous hospitality, but I won't be prevailing on it a moment longer. I'm sure that'll come as a great relief.
No, no, really, any time.
It's all right to be two-faced, Nancy. As long as you don't get caught.
Yeah, you should probably go and check on him.
Now she wears a conscience.
Plan's tracked down.
Well, clearly not that difficult. What do you want, Carl?
I was worried about you.
Look, I've been there many, many times, staring into the bottom of an empty bottle, and it's the only place to be.
Yeah, well, I like being alone, which is a polite way of saying, go away.
Nice. I forgave you a place to stay. Oh, James, you can't keep pushing everyone away. You're going to end up with no one.
I already have no one. Unless, that is, you fancy killing the boy.
You know, there's a reason why all your relationships are so toxic. Because you demand love and respect. You're never willing to earn it. And until you do, you're going to end up in the same place. Alone. Don't give up on your family, James. Go home and fight for what's yours.
Actually, Mother, it's my home.
I seem to remember chucking you out.
And now I'm back to reclaim what's mine. With post-its.
We don't want you here.
What you want, my dear, is immaterial. I pay the mortgage, I pay the bills. I even pay for that sandwich. Oh, you cut the crust off. How sweet. Now, I will allow you to remain here and play happy families as long as you keep your grasping little hands off all my things.